गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द ऑप्टिमाइजेशन चैप्टर, दैट इज लास्ट यूनिट. सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव लर्न द प्रोसेस कॉल्ड बायोडीजल प्रोडक्शन. सो इन द बायोडीजल प्रोडक्शन वी हैव लर्न हाउ टू कन्वर्ट एनी ऑयल और एनी फैटी एसिड विथ हेल्प ऑफ अल्कोहल टू द ईस्टर और द एस्टरीफिकेशन प्रोसेस. सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव सीन the transesterification process. So we have seen esterification process and transesterification process. So in esterification, generally any acid plus alcohol is going to form ester. In a transesterification process, so generally ester is again going to react with alcohol, going to form another form of ester and another form of alcohol. So that is called as a transesterification process. So in the last lecture, on the previous lectures, we have seen. So what is difference between esterification process and transesterification process? So generally transesterification process is used for the production of biodiesel. So also we have seen how to produce a biodiesel from the any particular vegetable oil. Okay, so in this particular process we have seen the any triglyceride is going to react with alcohol with help of certain acid or base catalyst and going to form a certain ester. So it could be the chain of ester. That is called as a ethyl ester of the fatty acid. So generally alcohol chain or ester chain would be called as a ester. Now we have to see how the any process or any biodiesel production can be optimized. So there are certain factors that are going to discuss while manufacturing the biodiesel. So any process or any chemical process we need to optimize before we have to do a large scale production. So in a green principle or green technology 12 principles are there that we have to incorporate in the any process. So in that one of the vital technology to incorporate this 12 principle is optimization. Using this optimization we are going to incorporate maximum number of principles so that the particular process will become a green, or the maximum principles are utilized and the process will become green oriented. Okay, so in the particular biodiesel production we have to apply different optimization technique. So there are 3 to 4 different principles are there that we have to adopt for the optimization. So first is methanol to oil ratio. That will be the most important factor to the optimization technique. Then second is amount of catalyst or catalyst concentration, and third or fourth is reaction time and reaction temperature. So on the basis of these 4 factors we are going to learn this kind of optimization technique. So individually these concepts are also asked for the short note. What mean by methanol to oil ratio, or they give short note. We have to explain this methanol to oil ratio in a short note. Also catalyst concentration is also asked for the short note. So we have to briefly explain this diagram and we have to mention how we are going to do optimization. Okay, the first factor is methanol to oil ratio. Okay, so methanol to oil ratio, in that we have to utilize a different methanol ratio. So methanol means alcohol. So we have to use a different ratio of methanol to oil. So we have to see a different ratio and we have to see what will be the triglyceride formation or triglyceride conversion. So that is triglyceride conversion means how much biodiesel is going to produce. So oil ratio generally we are going to take in the particular process will be 1:3, 1:6, 1:9 and 1:12. Stoichiometrically, the methanolysis of zoetrope oil requires 3 moles of methanol for each mole of oil. 3 moles of methanol means 3 parts will be alcohol and 1 part will be the oil. So obviously these are the reactants, oil that is fatty acid and methanol. So alcohol and oil as a fatty acid or the fatty acid are the one kind of ester. So ester plus alcohol is going to form a certain transesterification reaction, and in this process we are converting to the biodiesel. Okay, so since transesterification of triglyceride, it is reversible. That means reaction can be reversed. So excess methanol is required to shift the equilibrium towards the direction of ester formation. If you don't use the excess alcohol, obviously reaction would be reversible. So we have to use excess methanol to shift equilibrium towards the formation of ester. As seen from the various data, the maximum conversion is generated at the methanol to oil ratio 1:9 or 1:9. So generally 9 moles of alcohol and 1 mole of alcohol. So this is a 9 times excess the particular methanol. So we have plotted this particular graph from this particular